Welcome back to another video. In this video, we're gonna go over the steps to making this glitch transition effect. Let's get started. Okay, so I have my text layer placed in the center of my composition, which is set to 12 frames per second, by the way, because I feel like that gives the glitch effect the proper amount of choppiness. Higher frame rates, like 24 or 30 frames per second, feel a little too smooth for my liking. However, I want to emphasize that this is a matter of personal taste. Okay, so the first part of this effect is to create the digital wipe that will reveal the text and then hide it again. So to do this, first create a rectangle by going to Layer, New, Solid. This solid won't actually be visible in the final product, so the color is not important. But I do like it to be the size of my composition. Once I've done that, I'll hit OK. Now, there are two effects that we'll use that will create the pixelated border that falls off from completely opaque to completely transparent. The first is Roughen Edges, which will create the fall-off border, and then the Mosaic effect, which will make it look pixelated. So with the Roughen Edges effect applied, I'll crank up the border as far as it will go, all the way up to 500. And then I'll crank up the edge sharpness to 10. Next, I'll add the mosaic effect and adjust the horizontal and vertical blocks until I get the shape of blocks that I want. This is something that you will just have to finesse until it looks right. Next, to get rid of these hard edges that are created by the edges of the original solid that these effects are applied to, I will select the solid in my layer stack and then go up to the toolbar and double click on the rectangle tool to create a mask that is the same size as the solid. I'll open up the mask parameters by hitting MM on my keyboard and I'll reduce the mask expansion and increase the mask feather until there is a nice fall off without any harsh edges. Next, I'll add a simple expression to the evolution property of the roughen edges effect by holding Alt or Option if you're on a Mac and clicking on the stopwatch. In the text box, I'll add the expression time times 1000. This will take the current time of the playhead and multiply it by 1000 and use that resulting number for the evolution. The end result of this expression is to give the noise some randomness when it's played back. This is a super simple expression that will be repeated a few more times throughout this tutorial. The next step is to use the solid as the alpha mat that will reveal the text. To do this, first make sure that the solid layer is directly above your text layer. If your timeline has any other layers, make sure that there are no layers in between your text layer and this solid layer. The solid layer has to be directly above the text layer. On the text layer, set the track mat to alpha mat. If you do not see the track mat menu, you need to toggle to modes by clicking this button at the bottom. This will turn the visibility of the solid off, and there will be no changes to the text layer at this point. That is because the center of our solid is completely opaque, but as the solid slides over, the text layer will begin to disappear where the solid layer is transparent. This is how alpha mats work, by referencing the opacity of the pixels of the layer above. Next, we'll animate the solid to reveal, then hide the text. With the solid selected, hit P on your keyboard to open up the position property. Click on the stopwatch to begin animating. Make sure the opaque part of your solid is over the text. You'll know that it is if the text is visible. Drag that current keyframe out a few frames because this is where your animation is going to rest. Then with your playhead at the first frame, drag the solid left until you can no longer see the text. Play that back and make sure that the timing feels right, making adjustments if needed. Then move the playhead out to where you want to start transitioning out. Add a keyframe and then repeat the process, except this time move the solid off to the opposite side of the composition. And then, like always, play back your animation to make sure everything feels just right. Okay, so to finish up this part of the process, I'm going to rename this solid layer to Digital Wipe. Next, let's get started on creating the actual glitch effect. To do this, duplicate the solid layer and rename it to Displacement Map. For now, I'm going to turn the visibility back on. With the displacement map layer selected, go up to Layer, Solid Settings, and extend the width of the displacement layer. Hit OK. Now, as you can see, when I zoom out, the displacement layer solid is much wider than my composition. I'm going to move my playhead until this layer is centered on my text. Then I'm going to grab the edges of my mask and move them inward, but making sure that I don't go past the sides of my text. With this layer still selected, I'll hit M on my keyboard to bring up the mask properties, and I'm going to check this box right here next to invert. Now, if you've done everything correctly, where there was a white solid blob before, there should now be a cutout in the layer with white pixelated blobs on either side. When you play back the animation, your text should start out covered by the white pixelated blob, move to not being covered, then as it transitions out, the white blob on the left should cover the text again. You may have to make adjustments to the mask edges to make that work in that way. Next, add a fractal noise effect to the displacement map layer. We'll use this layer to create a random noise pattern that will later be used as a reference layer to scramble the pixels on our text layer. Set the fractal type to max and the noise type to block. This gives us the boxes we need to make this glitch look pixelated. However, we need more white and black boxes. Right now, all the boxes seem to be different shades of gray. So to do this, crank up the contrast and crank down the brightness until you see a good balance of white, black, and gray boxes. Open up the transform options in the effect panel and uncheck uniform scaling. And you can crank up the width and crank down the height. This part is more subjective and is just up to your own personal taste. Now, to make this glitch effect work, we need to repeat the process of adding the time expression to the evolution of the fractal noise effect so that, just like with the rough and edges effect earlier, this noise is shifting around randomly every frame. So, holding Alt or Option if you're on a Mac, click the stopwatch and add the expression time times 1000. So now we are pretty much done with this layer, except for some minor adjustments to the animation that we'll make later. At this point, we can go ahead and turn the visibility of this layer off again. Now we're going to add the displacement map effect to the text layer. The displacement map effect distorts the layer it is applied to according to the white, black, and gray values of a reference layer. First, we have to tell the displacement map effect which layer to reference for the distortion. I'll let you guess which layer we are going to choose. Hint, it's this one. Then we need to change source to effects and mask. If we don't change this source, the displacement map effect will ignore the fractal noise we just applied to this solid. However, even when we make this switch, nothing seems to happen. That's because we need to switch on the continuously rasterize on the displacement map layer. If you don't see these switches, it is because you may be still looking at the modes. So just click this button at the bottom to toggle back to switches. Now we're about 95% of the way done. We just need to make some minor adjustments to the keyframes of the displacement map layer by making sure that it slightly overlaps with the digital wipe layer. Our goal is for the digital wipe layer to be followed closely by the displacement map layer as it transitions in, and then vice versa as it transitions out. This can be usually done by just nudging the first two keyframes of the displacement map layer over a couple of frames. Then, at the transition out, we'll do the same thing, but to the last two keyframes of the digital wipe. You can either select the keyframes and drag them with your mouse, or you can hit Alt and left or right arrows to nudge your keyframes frame by frame. And then the last thing we need to do is just crank up the horizontal and vertical distortion of our displacement map so we get some real scrambling. Now that's pretty much it. Like always, play it back and make sure it's feeling real nice. Let's package up this animation by selecting all three of these layers and right-clicking on one of them and select Pre-Compose. Name this new composition something like Main Animation. Next, we'll add some static texture to the text itself. Now, We could make our own layer again using the fractal noise effect on a solid layer, but I want something a little bit more organic. So I'm going to use this VHS damage overlay that I downloaded from Envato Elements. Envato Elements is the sponsor of today's video, which is awesome because I love Envato Elements for things like this. I use Envato Elements for textures like this all the time, and so I'm pumped that they are sponsoring today's video. Unlimited downloads and straightforward licensing mean that I don't have to worry about that kind of stuff, and I can just focus on staying in that creative space. Envato Elements really is an unbeatable deal for content creators and creative professionals alike. So if you want to give Envato Elements a go and you appreciate the content we make here on this channel, support us by following the link in the description when you want to sign up and give it a whirl. Now back to the tutorial. Okay, so I'm going to place the video file in my timeline above my main animation composition. Then I'm going to set the mode to Silhouette Luma. This makes it so that the texture will only show through on the text. I'll select these two layers and right-click to pre-compose. I'll call this composition texture. Then I'll apply an effect called Shift Channels to my new composition. In the effects panel, I'll switch the green and blue channels to off, leaving the red untouched, which will turn my text to red. In the meantime, I'll duplicate my composition two times using Control or Command if you're on a Mac, and D. On this second composition, I will turn off the red channel and turn on the green channel. And on this top composition, I will turn off the red channel and turn on the blue channel. Then, selecting all three compositions, we just need to change the blending mode to add. Now the text should look white again. Now there are two different directions that I can go. I can offset these compositions so that they all play at different times, which will reveal that this little color effect we're going for with the glitch. But to me, that adds a little bit of smoothness to the animation that I don't want. Instead, I'm going to use an effect called Posterize Time, which changes the frame rate of the layer it is applied to. I'll apply it to the first layer and change the frame rate to 11. And then I'll copy that and paste it on the second layer, and then change the frame rate to 10. So now all three layers are playing at slightly different frame rates. The end result, in my opinion, accomplishes the same color effect, but maintains the choppiness that I like for the glitch effect. Now I'm going to select all three of these layers, right click and pre-compose, and I'll name this composition RGB Split. Now at this point, it's just more about stylizing the animation the way you want. You can apply another layer of glitchiness using the same combination of the displacement map and the fractal noise effect. You can add an effect called Colorama that gives the text some wild color changes over time. Shout out to Ben Marriott for this tip. Then finish off with some glow to just give it that final touch. Okay, so those are the basics of the glitch effect. I love the displacement map effect. It's one of my favorites to use because you can do so many cool things with it. In fact, I have a couple tutorials planned for how to use the displacement map effect in some other creative ways that I think you'll really like. So if you're interested in those tutorials, make sure you're subscribed and with the bell notification icon turned on so that you are notified whenever I post a new video. And if you found that this tutorial was helpful, make sure you hit that like button. It really does help me reach more people in the YouTube algorithm. And if you have any questions about this tutorial, hit me up in the comment section. Or if you have suggestions for future tutorials, hit me up in the comment section or shoot me an email. Anyway, thanks for watching and we'll see you all in the next video.
Cause mommy doesn't want to look after you.
Come here. Come here. Gonna be in my video. You wanna be in my video? Say hi, Butters. Hi, Butters. Hi. Say hi, Butters. Hey. Look at the camera. There you go. There you go. Hey.
Come here.
There you go. Say hi, Butters. Okay, she's being shy.